Krissy, I love that you're back in Maine.
Yo, what up, though? Calling for Krissy T.
Oh, it's Krissy.
What's she going to say next?
Krissy T in the morning, more like Krissy Unfiltered in the morning.
Maine's new way to wake up. Krissy in the morning on Portland's number one hit music station, Q97.9.
Yes, Krissy, you're on the queue. Let's go. Woo!
Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
If you can't say something nice, don't say nothing at all.
Krissy in the morning.
Thank you, Krissy, on Q97.9.
Good morning. Good morning.
Now, if any of you follow Kanye on the gram recently, have you unfollowed him yet? Have you unfollowed him yet? Because the photos and the videos he is putting up of his wife, who looks strikingly, almost scarily, exactly like his ex-wife, Kim Kardashian, he'd be posting her up in half-naked outfits. Sometimes there's outfits that cover her face. It's very bizarre. Sometimes he puts her up in this onesie that I don't even know if she could breathe in it. From top to bottom, you can't even see her face. You can't see her arms. You can't see anything. It's so weird. The relationship is so weird. I think it's safe to say that Kim Kardashian is doing a little bit better on her end. Who, by the way, apparently was in Maine recently. This isn't any Dave Portnoy story. This is A-list celebrity Kim Kardashian. And you know what? I might actually put Dave Portnoy probably in an A-minus celebrity category. But she was in Dara Muscata. That's so random. It's so random. And the way we found that out was she posted up a sign, which was outside of this little bar. And she put it up on her story. She tagged Khloe. And between the two of these Kardashian sisters, I mean, this thing went viral. They got a million hits in 24 hours. And so all the details on that, all the details that I know so far, because you know how celebrity news goes. We might find out new stuff later. But as far as I know, everything that I've got clocked down, everything that I've got in my little holster of tricks is up, trending right now on our Q97.9 app. If you want to go check out the sign, if you want to go read the rest of the details going on, WJBQ.com. Kim Kardashian seems pretty sweet. I'm not going to lie to you. She doesn't, I mean, you know, it doesn't really seem like there's much up there, but she's still sweet.
Oh, I love listening to Krissy in the morning.
Q97.9.
Let's see, which mic are you on? Give me a mic check.
Hi, everybody.
There you are. You're on number two.
Ah, I get to be number two today.
All right. Good morning. Happy Tuesday to Jack Harlow, my new boyfriend. I don't know if I told you this, Mike. I'm dating Jack Harlow now.
Jack Harlow?
Yeah, the guy that plays the song. Oh, my God. Off to a rough start on a top 40 station.
Oh, honey child. I got honey child myself.
Hey, welcome to the show, honey. If you are just tuning in to Krissy in the morning, this is Tarot Card Mike.
Mike the Tarot guy.
Yeah, he's coming in this week because you don't have work this week, right?
I don't. I'm on vacation.
Nice.
From my day job.
I love that. And he chose to want to come in here, so I appreciate you.
Well, Tuesday's the day I normally come.
Yeah, Tuesday you normally come in. So we might hear from you a little bit more this week.
I hope so, because I love coming in.
You're so cute. Well, it's funny because my first break of the show, and you texted me this, I'm wearing shorts right now. And that's just because it's not my choice. It's really cold out. It's because I got a huge tattoo on the back of my thigh because I'm trying to finish my leg sleeve. And for anyone listening right now that understands how tattoos work, you can't wear pants. You cannot wear pants for at least 5 days. It hurts. You're aquaphoring it. You're washing it. You just cannot wear pants. So I just opted, because everybody in the studio already knows I'm crazy, to wear shorts to work. And I am freezing. And you were like, I do that on purpose.
Oh, yeah. I have sandals on, too.
You even have flip-flops on.
No, Close. I mean, there are straps. I'd lose my shoes if they were.
This is so interesting to me. Here I am like, oh my God, everyone's going to think I'm crazy. And here you are. What did you say to me? You're embracing your inner winter.
Oh, I'm embracing my inner winter realness.
Okay.
Which is shorts and sandals.
And you said you've done this for a long time, too. Like, you used to wait at the bus stop? Like
oh, yeah. So, family, friend, neighbor, Mike Stash would always, and even today, I go to his house in flip-flops, sandal, you know, shorts. He's like, I remember you 20 years ago waiting for that bus
as a
wearing
kid.
The same thing.
That is so interesting.
Some things never change.
Stay true to yourself, babe. Stay true to yourself. I'm over here freezing. You're over there loving it.
I'm actually overheating right now.
Yeah.
This is a hot.
Yeah, I have goosebumps. We are not the same.
It's Mike the Tarot Guy. Honey Chow. Mm-hmm. Krissy, we need to spill the tea.
Q97.9.
I still love that.
I will always love that. But like I said, it's time to spill the tea, right?
I know.
Are we spilling tea? Please.
We're going to spill the tea. Now, this is the funniest part is... So you know that I've been dating a new man.
Yes.
For the last 3-4 months.
Yep.
This man is absolutely wonderful. He gives me no reason to think he's cheating. It's my own PTSD traumas. And we all know what that's like. We exude it onto somebody that it doesn't belong exuding on.
Absolutely.
But when they love you, they deal with it. They deal with it. So I pulled a little funny last night. I like to call it funny. My boyfriend calls it a little crazy. Tomato, tomato. Okay. Now, I'm sitting next to him on the couch and he's absolutely amazing. So, you know, I just got my new tattoo and it's very hard for me to walk because here, look. It's my whole calf.
Oh my God.
Look.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's my whole calf. And anyone listening right now who has gotten a huge tattoo on their calf, you know, you can't walk for a few days. It's very, very difficult. So he's been taking care of me like the sweetheart that he is. And we're sitting there on the couch, right? Just picture this. He buys me dinner, right? And we're eating takeout. We're just having a nice little night. And he hears this. And I'm sitting in the corner of the couch, right, Mike? And I'm looking at him.
Yep.
Waiting. I'm waiting for the response. I see him on his phone. And I'm like, wait till he gets it.
She's waiting.
And his phone goes like this.
Really?
It's the Facebook Messenger.
Why? You're sitting right there.
Well, I'm sitting right there. Well, so get this. I'm on my Krissy T Radio fan page, and I'm on Marketplace, right?
Yep.
And he's selling a couple things. He's selling a pair of his shoes, a very expensive pair of shoes. He's selling an end table that he made, stuff like this. Yeah.
End tables?
Yeah. My Valentine's, I forgot to tell you this. My Valentine's Day gift, he made me a farmhouse end table because I have the full set. But I just can't seem to find the perfect end table, so he built it for me, him and his grandfather. Isn't that very sweet?
Oh, my God. How much does he pay for those? I need a new end table.
Yeah, maybe I can get him to make you one, too. He loves me enough where he probably would. So, anyways, I'm looking over at him, and I'm waiting for the response. And there's girlies right now that are like, oh, yeah, I've been there. And his phone goes like this. That is the messenger itself. And so I'm on my fan page and I respond to his Marketplace message and I go, I'm like, hey, these shoes look really nice. But the guy that's selling them looks even nicer. Is he available?
Oh, honey child, you did it.
I did. I don't know if I was bored or if he's just too good to me where I just had to stir it up a little bit. And there's somebody listening right now that's like, yes, been there. I was bored. He's too good to me. I had to stir it up.
I can see his face right now. Was it like this?
Yes. He looks at his phone. He goes, really? He's like, I'm right here. You can just ask me. I'm like, I just wanted to see what you would do. So then we start role playing and I'm like, okay, so if a girl decides to message you about your shoes, how are you answering? And he's like, what are you saying right now?
Oh,
what
no.
is wrong with you?
Oh no.
And then his phone goes like this.
Was it you again?
It was me again.
Of course.
I go to the bathroom and I message him again from the bathroom. I am sitting on the toilet and I go, I pretend like I'm a girl and I'm like, really interested in these shoes. Is there any way we can meet up tonight? And I go, I'm a cute little blonde girl. Do you have a girlfriend? And he comes knocking on the door, and he's like, what are you doing? He's like, what is it? What is happening? What is that? I go, answer. I want to see what you would do. He's like, what are we doing right now? And I was like, we're role playing. I want to see how you would handle it if a girl messaged you on Facebook. And then his phone just goes.
That's my favorite noise.
You want to hear it again?
Yes.
That's his brain. This is what I envision his brain feeling when he's like, oh my God, my girlfriend is a nutcase. Just. And he goes, I don't have the right answer right now. I don't have that. He's like, I'm damned if I do. I'm damned if I don't. And I go, and keep in mind, the door is closed. The bathroom door is closed. We're yelling at each other. And he's like, do you want me to answer you, or I could just answer you in person? And I go, no, I want you to answer the Facebook message.
Oh my God.
He goes, it's you, babe. It's you. What are you doing? And I go, well, then answer it. I want to know what you would do. And then I hear his phone again from inside the bathroom just.
You know, this is some role play thing you got going on here.
Yeah, I don't know if it was, and it wasn't meant to be sexual. It wasn't like a role play thing. I just like to play. I play too much.
Oh, hi, child, you're just silly.
Yeah, like it's just, I apparently just play too much. Oh my God, it was so funny. And so he ends up messaging me back, and he goes, you know what? I'm going to read it to you.
Oh, please do.
Let me find it really quickly. And it, again, he has. There's no reason for me to have done this. He does not give me any reason for me. I guess I wouldn't call myself toxic. I think I just play too much.
Well, while you're finding that, at least you do that with your boyfriend. I find people on Marketplace. I'm like,
do you flirt with people on Marketplace?
Every so often, I'm like, hey, you know, not interested in what you're selling, but you're kind of attractive or you're kind of cute. And they're like, I'm straight. And I'm like, life story. Just take the compliment. Move on.
Oh, no. So you find people on Facebook Marketplace.
I don't poach people specifically for that. But
if it happens, it happens.
I mean, I'm looking for a new apartment right now. And
yeah, you are. It's a good place to do it.
And so I'm on there all the time. And there are places I definitely can't afford.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm like, but, oh, well, this guy's hot. So
See what I mean? And my boyfriend, I'm telling you. My boyfriend's sexy, and you know it.
Oh.
I've shown you photos. Yeah. He's this blue-eyed, 6'4". He's got a mullet with black hair. Oh, he's beautiful. He's gorgeous.
He's 6'4"?
Oh, yeah, he's gorgeous.
I know that, like, all women care about that.
We do, especially when you're me and you're 5'7".
I mean, the mullet thing.
Oh, don't even right now. Don't even. He shaves the sides, and the mullet comes in. Oh, my God, he's beautiful.
I mean, he pulls it off.
He pulls it off. So I found the message. So, here's me. Here, let me just.
Every time. I love it.
Hey, I couldn't help but notice the guy selling this is very cute. Is this available? And I go, I could give cash later on today. And he goes, I'm so sorry, but the man in this photo is not available. I go, good answer. I'm like, you know what? Good for you, babe. So I go, what if I told you I'm a cute little tattooed blonde? Because he loves tattooed blondes. And I go, would it be available then? This is what he said. And this is from the other side of the couch. No, he is very committed to his girlfriend, and she is very scary. And for yours and his safety, let's drop this discussion. And I go, good job, Dave. It's exactly what you're supposed to do. And I go, damn, but what if I told you I have a big booty and a leg sleeve? Because he likes the booty and the leg sleeve. I go, would it be available then? He goes, no, sorry. The man that owns these shoes is actually blind and deaf. I'm sorry. And then he blocked my account. And he opens the door to the bathroom. And he's like, are you serious? Was that good enough for you?
Are you satisfied now?
Are you satisfied now? I was like a Snickers. Yes, I am. Good job, babe.
Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
Toxic traits. It's one of those things where we all have them. But I'll admit them for you, because there's a lot of people that won't admit that they do a little toxicity dance. Hello, good morning. You're on Krissy in the morning.
Good morning.
Good morning, honey. What is your toxic trait? Give it to me.
Oh, my God. I have so many.
You're like, I am just riddled with toxicity.
Which one do I pick?
Tell me a couple of them. I bet I could relate to them.
I can do whatever I want, but you can't do the things that I do, because then I'm like, I'll get mad.
Yeah, you're a hypocrite. That for me,
I'm a hypocrite.
For me, I'm single and you're in a relationship. Get over it.
Yeah, exactly. Like sometimes I'll go on
kidding,
a girl's trip
kidding.
And that leaves my husband to be home alone. But he loves that. He likes to be home alone.
Yeah.
But if he goes on a trip without me, I throw a fit because I don't like to be home alone.
Oh, yeah. My little toxic baby, huh?
Yeah, it's for sure. Yeah. For sure. Yeah, yeah. We all have them.
Yeah, here's my thing. We all do these things and we feel these things. And I bet you there's so many people listening right now that are like, yes, me too. They just don't want to admit it. We're the kind of people that admit it. I'll say it.
Oh, I am very aware of my flaws. Yeah. They're there.
Yes.
I'll just apologize. What is it? Apologize, don't ask for permission.
Yeah, I would rather beg for forgiveness than ask for permission.
Yeah, exactly.
That is also how I live my life.
I mean, I'm not that bad. I don't do any crazy stuff anymore. I am out of my 20s.
Oh, she's anymore. Girl, I get it. My 20s were full of what the hells.
Yeah, I did it all in my 20s. I got it out there. I married later on, so yeah, I was wise.
Yeah. I look back on my life, I'm like, damn, I was just one big toxic little girl.
I know. I have an 18-year-old daughter, and I'm just like so fearful.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. She's about to enter it. Here we go. Yeah.
She's a good child.
That's all right. As long as you admit it and you work on it. Like, I tell my boyfriend every day, I'm like, I will go crazy on him for no reason. And he's so used to it that he looks at me and he goes, are you done yet? And I go, I'm so sorry. That was a little too crazy.
Oh, 100%. I have, like, the best husband ever. He's so patient with me. He just lets me have my fit. And then he just, sometimes he'll even apologize when he did nothing wrong.
Yeah, see, that's the thing. That's important. Get you a man that apologizes. When he knows he did nothing wrong because his girl is cry-cry. Yep. I got you,
I
Billy.
Hope you guys get some great stories this morning.
Well, we just got a couple of them. Thank you, babe.
You're welcome.
Have a good day and try to go to therapy today, okay?
Okay, thank you.
I want therapy.
Hi.
My phone line is open right now, 775-7979. What is your toxic trait?
I have never heard someone say so many wrong things.
I know you got them.
One after the other, consecutively in a row. Cute.
Oh, baby. You naughty little biscotti. Why don't you just
meet me in the middle? Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
Q97.9, hello.
Hello.
What's up, honey?
My toxicity is, one, again, self-sabotage. I heard you say that earlier.
Yeah.
It's a thing.
I don't know why. I'm like, oh, my life is really good right now. What can I do to twist it all up for myself?
1,000%. Girl, 1,000%.
Yeah, it's like I'm comfortable in the chaos. You know what I mean?
Yes. Even like my life, I call it organized chaos.
Yeah, organized chaos. I actually thrive very well in organized chaos. I get it. There's people like that.
My second one is I tell my husband, oh, yeah, go ahead and do that. Have fun when it's not including me. And then he actually does it, and then I'm pissed off.
I hate it when people do things that I tell them to do.
I can't. I'm like, go ahead and have fun. And then I'm like, well, I wanted to have fun too. What the heck?
Yeah, like how can you not read my toxic yet? I'm setting you up. And
I've been with my husband for 24 years, and he still falls for that every single time.
Oh my God. Well, then it might be time for a new husband, because how am I setting you up?
Oh, no. Never, ever. We've been together since we were 15.
I'm kidding. See,
my forever and always.
See, my toxic trait. I was self-sabotaging for you. You see what I mean? I couldn't even handle that.
He gets my self-sabotaging, and he helps me get out of it. And like I said, he's a keeper.
That is so important, because my boyfriend does the same thing. So you know what? He is a keeper, and we're going to get through this together, girlfriend. I'll see you in therapy.
All right, I'll be there next Tuesday.
Perfect. I'll meet you there at 1 o'clock sharp after the show.
Perfect. Have a great day.
Bye, baby.
Portland's number one hit music station, Q97. W.
It's Mike the Tarot Guy. Honey Chow. Mm-hmm. Krissy, we need to spill the tea.
Q97.9.
We got a special edition for you today.
Special.
It's because we've been talking about our toxic traits, and this is one of those things where everybody has them, but it's funny to call them out. We've all got flaws. We've all got our little toxic traits that we can't control. You just got to find somebody who will put up with it. So it's interesting from your side of things, Mike, and again, welcome to the show. For those of you that are just tuning in, Mike is a tarot card reader.
Yes.
Yep. And a very excellent one at that. So, again, thank you for reading all of our listeners as they call in and they're like, oh my gosh, Krissy, I too am a self-sabotager. And you made a great point. You're like, I think I can tell you why you guys are kind of doing this.
Yeah. You know, there's a core reason why all of us self-sabotage. And yeah. It's great because just like with every time I do this, the cards just fly out. And
they do.
Like,
I've been learning that.
Yeah. And I mean, and usually when the cards fly out of the deck, the way that they do, it indicates that the universe needs us to know this. So here's knowledge from the divine.
Okay, I like that. Here, I got something for you. Ready?
All right. You were at Hogwarts. Yay, divination class. Okay.
Oh my goodness. You are something.
Hufflepuff for life. Okay. Yeah, yeah. So let's start in with the tarot. Okay. So we're going to start with the core of why we do these things that we do. And we got the Nine of Swords. Nine of Swords is all about fear, but crippling fear.
Oh.
So our toxic traits come from a place where we're afraid of how we're going to be perceived. If we're going to be rejected or not. And these fears influence how we act. And how we react to situations. If you've been cheated on and broken up with many times, then that fear exists and it kind of, you know, it can overtake your life.
Yeah.
Now, how is this affecting us? This can kill anything that we are trying to do in life. So, we're talking about self-sabotage. We're talking about crippling fear. If you've been cheated on, that could end a relationship that you start in the future.
Totally.
Because you are, projecting the negativity that happened in the past onto the current present situation.
Yeah.
And so the Ten of Swords is telling us that kaputnik, this ends now. This no good. And, you know, it's blowing up in our face. You know, it's time for us to move on. So be careful about how you let the past influence the present.
I would say that's probably one of the bigger things that most people around me do in life.
Yeah.
It's hard not to. It's so hard not to.
And I'm case in point.
Yes.
You know, I mean,
yeah, we all are really
everybody. And it doesn't have to be just relationships. It could be anything.
Yeah.
It could be anything in life. So, what happens if we get past this? We have the Chariot, which indicates forward movement, progression. Things are going to get better. It's positively aspected. So, if we are able to let go.
Yeah, that's the hardest part is the letting
go.
Let it go.
I need a little Elsa that I can tap on the head and everybody will know exactly what it's talking about.
It's funny. I just watched Frozen the other day and Olaf?
Yeah,
Olaf is one of my favorite.
That does not surprise me.
He was like, you know what? I remember the quote. He was like, some people are worth melting for.
Aw,
shucks. Like, stop
it. Krissy, you're worth melting for.
You're also worth melting for,
Mike. Aw, thank you. All right. So how can we move beyond these things? Like, how can we get over our situations, you know, that hold us back?
Yeah.
Therapy. Yay.
Therapy.
We've been talking about all morning. Let's all go to therapy together.
Therapy, you know what? And I want to say this. Let's normalize therapy. And I know that a lot of people right now, it's becoming a thing to be more open about needing to go to therapy. I mean, I think everybody should do it on a normal basis.
Yep.
It
absolutely
should be a part of life because I realize it the most when I go to my hairdresser because I get things out.
Yep.
And she always says to me at the end, she's like, girl, you would benefit so much from going to therapy because it's just getting things out and you're not jumbling your thoughts in your head. And you should never be ashamed of going to therapy.
Exactly.
You
exactly.
know?
Society tells us, especially with men, society tells us that we cannot share our feelings.
Oh, it's so true.
And that is the furthest from the truth. If people started sharing their feelings on a regular basis and actually started processing through those things, we'd have a very different society.
Oh, I 100% agree with you. It's like, I feel like a lot of men don't even know what they're thinking anymore or feeling anymore because they don't let their truth out.
Yeah, and the other half of men, they get angry because they don't have the opportunity to really be able
to outlet.
Exactly.
They don't
and
have the
so
outlet. Yep.
Sometimes that transfers into something unhealthy.
Totally.
You know, and this is where, you know,
that's their own self-sabotage.
Yeah, exactly. And this is where unhealthy traits come in. Moving forward, we've got animals and goddess here. I'm going to go through really quickly.
On the cards, yeah.
Yeah, on the cards. And, you know, for those who don't like goddesses, our animals, we got goose, walrus, and camel.
Ooh.
Basically saying we need to take a step back to rest, to recover, to heal ourselves, to acknowledge our pain, to acknowledge and accept that bad things have happened to us.
Yeah.
And that's okay. But we need to be able to process through them and let them go so we can move on and have a fruitful tomorrow that's not holding us back. Walrus tells us that we need to be vigilant about okay. our behaviors. So if we have toxic traits, acknowledging them when they happen and not beating ourselves up. We need to be kind to ourselves, everybody. Honey Childs, be kind to yourself and move on. You know, try to let them go and stop those from happening. Sedna and Camel are both telling us that we have what we need to be successful. It's just a matter of confronting ourselves and confronting our bad behavior so we can change those behaviors and replace them with positive ones.
Is that like accepting?
Yep.
Kind of. It's like
yep.
accepting what's, yeah, okay. I think that was my biggest lesson I've learned this year in my life so far, is accepting that, wow,
right.
that feeling sucked. What can I do about it?
Exactly.
Yeah.
And at the same time, accepting that this is what happens now,
mm-hmm.
it does not have to happen in the future, but it takes time. These things do not happen overnight. They can take years.
Yeah.
For me, it took almost 10 years for me to really process through my trauma. And
it's actually, you know what? Side note, it's really good to hear you say that. And I think a lot of people listening right now probably feel a little bit of relief too, because I think people think it's instant gratification when you're going through something that you should just be able to turn around and put it in the back and you're weak if you're thinking about it every day. But for me, I'm still processing a breakup that I just had.
Yeah.
And that was 6 months ago.
Yeah. You know, it takes time and baby steps. That's the thing. You can't jump into, you know, doing something that's really intense right away.
Yeah.
You don't have the skills and the foundation to do that. So baby steps.
Build the foundation first.
Exactly. Build yeah. a strong foundation so that tower doesn't collapse on you.
God, ain't that the truth. There's some days where I think I have it all together. And then the next day I'm like, nope, here I go. Like a Jenga tower.
And, you know, it's one step forward, two steps back.
Yeah.
You know,
as long as you keep taking those steps forward.
Exactly. And be patient. Again, all of this stuff takes time. Our brains are wired the way that they are because that helps us normalize the life that we're in.
Mm-hmm.
So if we are in a very uncontrollable, toxic environment, our brain is going to try and normalize that. Right.
Oh, and that's a great point.
It takes a while to unwire
What it's used to. The toxic behavior.
And then rewire it. And then rewire it or reprogram it to a healthier, you know, behavior.
See, who needs a therapist when we have Mike the Tarot Guy? I'm going to hit commercials real quick. If anybody would like to call in right now that wants to make a comment or has a question while we have Mike and, you know, his awesome services in here, please let us know. 775-7979. Why did that sound so commercially?
I don't know.
Please let us know. Call this number. No, call the show. Hang out with us.
Krissy in the morning on Q97.9.
Oh my gosh, my hat got stuck on my headphones. That was fun. Okay, Kayla, are you there? Hello. Good morning.
Good morning. I just had to call and say hi to Mike.
Well, good morning. Hello. What's your name?
Hi, it's Kayla.
Hi, Kayla.
Hey, Kayla.
Hey, AKA Tumblr girl.
Ooh, Tumblr girl.
Because he knows what that's about.
Oh, I know Tumblr girl. What's up, baby?
Hey.
How you doing? What's going on?
Oh, I just met Mike, and he's my guy, so I had to say hi. And I had to say hi to Krissy and get Mike's input on not Tumblr guy. I gotta see what Mike's thoughts are on my new guy.
Yes, I love this. Let's get juicy. This is exactly what I want to happen on the show. Let's go. Tell us a little bit about him.
All right. Well, he's super sweet, a little older. He puts a lot of effort in.
Are there any red flags?
All the time. Not yet.
Okay.
Not yet. But Mike has told me to beware before, and he was right.
I've told you to beware before? Oh, goodness.
That's all I have.
All right. So the feelings that I'm getting right now, because I also have that intuitive piece, you know.
You are very good with intuitive.
And I feel like, you know, you really hit the nail on the head with the sweet piece. I was thinking to myself, you know, as stuff was coming through, he's a sweet guy. But he's a little bit reserved. And you mentioned that he's a little bit older, so he's probably experienced some things in life as well. Would you say he's a shy person and he's having a difficult time really expressing himself?
No, I think he's actually been really, like, emotionally mature and able to express himself better than most guys.
Well, I am very glad to hear that. Let me, you know what, real quick, let me pull some cards, see what we got. And is there anything that you're concerned about in regards to this guy?
We had a not-so-great interaction a couple of years ago.
Okay.
Where we didn't talk for a bit.
Okay. Would you say that it was kind of an explosive fight? Or would you say that it was more like passive-aggressive internalized? Because I don't see him as a very, you know, aggressive sort of violent type.
No. It was more, I would say, I wouldn't even call it passive-aggressive. I would say he got, like, scared away.
I'm sorry. He got what?
I would say, if anything, I think he got scared away.
He got scared away. Okay.
Mm.
Interesting. So, so again, you know, kind of that more, I don't want to use the word submissive, but, he's, again, I would say probably not the typical guy that, you know, society tells us that we have to be, definitely in touch with his feelings.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, do you still have any residual sort of, feelings or sort of maybe judgments about that?
I don't think so. I think I've kind of moved on from the past.
Okay. And is he back in your life?
Yeah.
Okay. I get the feeling that whatever went down back then may have triggered something in regards to that situation you were just talking about, but I feel like it's probably resolved itself within him and also probably within yourself. I'm not getting anything that would indicate a bad relationship or anything like that. So I think he's a keeper.
Fantastic.
She's like, I'm going to go propose right now.
Get that U-Haul.
Bonding girl does that. Take control, babe. Not the nervous laugh. She's like, ha, ha, ha. Yeah, Krissy. Ha, ha, ha.
Mike the Terror Guy, are you sure you're done? There's things you don't know yet.
Right. Krissy in the morning.
Your shirt's six sizes too small, Fatso.
Q97.9.
So we've established that we don't know who Bryce Hall is, but we do know who Billie Eilish is. Of course, we play her music. She is a badass. She came up from nothing. She's very young, but she did the work. And so she was invited to the People's Choice Awards. Now, here's the thing that I don't know that I agree with. She did trash the amount of TikTokers at the People's Choice Awards. And this was Sunday night. Here's my thing. I understand why TikTokers are there. It is a big part of our social media culture, right? And I mean, you and I, we're not the biggest TikTokers, but we know the name of the game.
Yeah.
You know, we know that TikTok right now is huge.
Oh, absolutely. It's blowing up.
You could launch a business on TikTok.
I should launch a business on TikTok.
And, well, exactly. And then you'll get invited to the People's Choice Awards. However, Billie, she just didn't like it. She was seen talking to one of her friends, Kylie, and she was criticizing the amount of them that were at the People's Choice Awards. So that's basically insinuating that she doesn't believe that they are good enough, talented enough, or did the work enough is what I'm assuming. I'm not going to put words in her mouth to be there. There was a content creator. His name is Bryce Hall. He heard about it and he had something to say. So he sarcastically apologized for basically not acknowledging Billie's greatness the way she kind of made it seem like they should. I pulled the audio. Here it is.
I'm just going to address this clip of Billie Eilish being disgusted that TikTokers were at the People's Choice. I was one of them. First off, Billie Eilish, I am so sorry that I didn't acknowledge your greatness and bow down to you being another human being. There it is right now. And second, People's Choice invited us personally. Everyone that attended People's Choice and was sitting at those tables, we were invited by People's Choice. So hate on them. But the most sad thing, let me just wipe my tear real quick. The most sad thing is what I was a Billie Eilish stan. I stand you, Billie Eilish. And now I don't think I can renegade to any of your songs anymore. So thanks for taking out all my content.
This is interesting. Now, I just wonder if he's... Bryce, are you big enough to do this? Are you big enough to say this about Billie Eilish, who is very much big enough to be at the People's Choice Awards? Now, I guess the question here lies, are we okay with sharing the fame that TikTokers get instantly overnight? I mean, I know that that doesn't sit well with people. And, Mike, I don't know if you have an opinion on that at all. Or maybe you just want to stay quiet. I don't know. It's a tough it's a tough situation.
Yeah,
I mean, TikTokers being famous overnight, how do you feel about that?
Yeah,
that's... I almost feel like they didn't do the work.
I mean, that, to me, you know, you got to put the work in. You got to... But... With that being said, how much work are TikTokers actually doing? Because there are some
That's fair.
Who really put a lot of work and effort into making videos.
And creating
some people
content.
Just, right, exactly.
Yeah.
So I guess it really depends on the type of work you're doing. If you're just recording yourself, and my God.
Yeah, oh,
and responding
God, the worst,
to something.
The worst.
Not so much.
The worst. I guess I could see it from both point of views, but we have to start accepting that TikTokers are now famous. I see them everywhere. They're on the red carpet at all these events, standing next to Beyonce.
Which is completely insane in my mind.
Or Christina Aguilera. I'm like, what? These people did the damn work. But, you know, I guess that's our culture.
You know, it's one of those things where our media is evolving.
Yes.
And, you know, this is the next step, next evolution.
It's true.
And I got my degree in filmmaking, and they're saying...
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
That's really cool.
They're saying that films are going to be a thing of the past, and people can't sit through things for more than 30 seconds without touching their phone. So TikTok's going to be the new thing because
Because you're already on your phone.
Exactly.
That's a great point. Okay, you know what, TikTokers? Go off. You're allowed to be at the People's Choice Awards.
Portland's number one hit music station, Q97.9.
Morning. Hi, Krissy in the Morning. This is Donovan. If you learn from your mistakes, that's good. And if you don't, I don't know what to tell you, honestly.
Q97.9. We're the
best. Hello. Good morning.
Good morning, Krissy.
Good morning, babe. How are you?
I'm all right. How are you guys?
We're so good. You sound like you're in a wind tunnel.
Oh, I'm sorry. Here, hold on. Is that better?
Oh, that's so much better. Okay, where are we at?
So my toxic trait would have to be I was disciplined as a child, and I have three kids, so 13, 16, and 21. And I never really ever instilled discipline or grounding.
Okay.
So my toxic trait would be like anytime my kids are upset, I feel terrible.
Okay, and then you end up giving them whatever they want?
I give in, yeah. I'm a very, very easy given person. Like, you're grounded from your phone for the weekend. And by, you know, 11 o'clock Friday night, they're like, oh, I really need to talk to blah, blah, blah. I'm like, all right, I guess so.
Yeah, and you're like, okay, here you go. And they know that, too. They probably know that.
Oh, yes, they do, very much so. They know mama's the give-in person, so.
But it just means you have a heart.
Yeah, and you are not alone.
Yeah.
I know plenty of people who do that.
I know plenty of people that don't discipline their kids, I'll tell you that much.
I won't even take a management role at work because I don't want to have people under me that I have to discipline. So like, I just
deep?
Like to work by myself, leave me alone, so I don't have to ever be mean.
It is that deep for you. That is so funny.
Yeah, I just can't do it. I don't like to tell people no, and it's terrible.
You know,
there are worse things.
Yeah, there are worse things because it's better than you being on the other side and loving to tell people what to do because that always sucks.
That's true. But I think if there was a toxic trait, that would
Your toxic be my trait is top. You don't know how to ground your kids.
Yes.
Neither did my
help.
Mom.
No.
Have you seen me? I'm full of tattoos.
I guess you could say that takes the cake.
Oh, whatever that meant.
Oh, man.
Well, you guys have a terrific day, and we'll talk again soon.
I love it. Right, bye, honey. You. Have a good day.
Well, good morning, Krissy.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Noise.
Noise who?
Nice to see you. How are you?
Nice to see you.
Q97.9.
Q97.9, hello.
Hello.
What's up, honey?
My toxicity is, one, again, self-sabotage. I heard you say that earlier. Yeah. 1,000%.
It's a so thing. Gross. It's a thing. I don't know why. I'm like, oh, my life is really good right now. What can I do to twist it all up for myself?
1,000%. Girl, 1,000%.
Yeah, it's like I'm comfortable in the chaos. You know what I mean?
Yes. Even like my life, I call it organized chaos.
Yeah, organized chaos. I actually thrive very well in organized chaos. I get it. There's people like that.
My second one is I tell my husband, oh, yeah, go ahead. Go ahead and do that. Have fun when it's not including me. And then he actually does it, and then I'm pissed off.
I hate it when people do things that I tell them to do.
I can't. I'm like, go ahead, have fun. And then I'm like, well, I wanted to have fun, too. What the heck?
Yeah, like, how can you not read my toxic yet? I'm setting you up. And
I've been with my husband for 24 years, and he still falls for that every single time.
Oh, my God. Well, then it might be time for a new husband, because how am I setting you up?
Oh, no. Never, ever. We've been together since we were 15.
I'm kidding. See, my
toxic... forever and always.
See, my toxic trait. I was self-sabotaging for you. You see what I mean? I couldn't even handle that.
He gets myself sabotaging, and he helps me get out of it. And like I said, he's a keeper.
That is so important, because my boyfriend does the same thing. So you know what? He is a keeper, and we're going to get through this together, girlfriend. I'll see you in therapy.
All right, I'll be there on next Tuesday.
Perfect. I'll meet you there at 1 o'clock sharp after the show.
Perfect. Have a great day.
Bye, baby.
Krissy in the Morning on Q97.9.